Okay, I'm trying not to cry. Tomorrow we're going to celebrate my oldest niece graduating from high school. So Taylor, I'm going to send this one out to you as well as the graduating class of 2015. And also to all the moms out there who have been blessed. This is going to be your Mother's Day song to my mom, Marcia Harmon, to my grandmother, Martha McDowell. I'm trying not to cry. For those of you who don't know, I have PCOS, and it's polycystic ovarian syndrome. My biggest wish in the whole entire world has always been, and forever will be, to be a mom. But right now, the tunnel is very dark on that because I canceled my appointment twice to my doctor that I was supposed to go to, the specialist, and mainly because of fears. I was fearful of what they would find if I did go, because I have so many outstanding bills that my dreams may never come true. And it hurts. It hurts like heck. Yes, but it's my own fault, and I know that. But to know that there could be something wrong and I'm not going to fix it, I blame myself. And, I'm going to try and not do this. my best wish of all has always been to be a wife first and then a mother. One of my dear friends today, said to me if she was ever pregnant, she would be, she knew how much it meant to me, she would hand over the kid to me, which that was the sweetest thing that somebody has said to me in quite some time. I've always wanted to be a mom. I still do. I'm just scared that it won't happen at age 37. So I'm going to send this one out to all of us girls with PCOS as well, who every Mother Day that we're not a mother is hard on us. And it's just a hard holiday. Probably the hardest holiday to get through. With that being said, let's sing this song now if I can get through it. It probably won't be perfect, but I'm no singer. But with the best of intentions for all children out there, I hope you dance.
May you never take one single breath for granted. God forbid love ever leave you empty-handed. I hope you still feel small when you stand beside the ocean. Whenever one door closes, I hope one more opens. Promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance, I hope you dance. I hope you dance. I hope you never feel those mountains in the distance. Never settle for the path of least resistance. Living might mean taking chances, but they're worth taking. Loving might be a mistake, but it's worth making. Don't let some hell choice to sit it out or dance. I hope you dance. I hope you dance. I hope you dance. I hope you dance. A smile when you stand beside the ocean. Whenever one door closes, I hope one more opens. Promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance. And when you get the choice to sit out or
I'm very proud of my eldest niece, Taylor. She's going to college this year, and I know that she's probably going to be in accounting because she is so smart at math and just a whiz. And to the PCOSers out there, I don't want to say that I'm giving up, but I know, leave it in God's hands, and He knows the whispers of my heart, and He knows the prayers in my heart, but I've had such a struggle, such a hard road with love, that every time I start to believe, something goes wrong. And with my PCOS, I know that I'm working against a time clock, and financially, I'm definitely struggling right now. If God up there can hear my prayers, which I know He does because He's always listening, I would be able to fulfill my dreams. But I don't think that's going to happen for me. But I urge all of you out there who have children who are blessed and to have that wonderful title to be called mother, to know what you have and don't take a single day for granted. It's so hard to go out there and see the kids shopping with their fathers, buying gifts, and gonna be able to celebrate it with their moms and know that they're loved and appreciated. So I also want to say to my mother and my grandma, you're both appreciated more than words can say. I hope to share that title someday. Children are blessings and angels from God. And we should thank God for kids. Without kids, there'd be no magic. There would be just, this world wouldn't be as great as it is. We wouldn't have a bright future like we do. I know I shouldn't be greedy, and I should appreciate the life I have. But when you get down to it, the blonde bombshell, what does she really have other than costumes? And looks fade after a while, don't they? With that being said, good night.